Welcome to GTV. Today I will be showing you how to do a basic startup of Eaton Cutler-Hammer's PowerXL DG1 AC drive. After verifying that the unit is wired up correctly, the drive can be powered on and ready to program. Taking a look at the keypad, I can see three LEDs to indicate a run condition, a fault condition, and the method of control of the drive, such as local or remote. There is also an arrow pad to move between parameter menus as well as select values. The back and reset button is used to back up a step during programming and to reset fault conditions during run mode. The OK button is used to confirm edits and selections. The green button here is for starting a motor, and the red button is for stopping the motor. The last two buttons are soft keys. These will have a few different tasks depending on the current operation displayed on the LCD screen. For example, in run mode, these keys can be used to select the direction of the motor. I will be showing two ways to set up the drive. One way is to use the startup wizard, and the other way is to find each parameter groove and to change them accordingly. The startup wizard will prompt the user to begin upon startup from default settings. If the startup wizard does not appear on power-up, then it may have already been initiated before. The setting for the startup wizard can be found on the main menu. Once prompted to use the startup wizard, I can push the OK button. Here I can enter the language. Next is the real-time clock, where I can set year, months, and day, as well as hours, minutes, and seconds. The next step is daylight savings, which can be set to off, European or American daylight savings time. Now I am prompted for the application. This will determine many factors as to how the motor will run and how the drive is set up. My options are standard, multi-pump, multi-PID, and multi-purpose. I will keep this at standard for this demonstration. Next is the setting for minimum frequency, followed by the maximum frequency setting. I will keep these values at the default and proceed to the motor nominal current. This can be found on the motor's nameplate. The next setting is current limit. I will keep this at the default, which is set to the nominal current of the drive. Next is my motor speed, which is listed in RPM on the nameplate. Keep in mind that the values that I am putting in here reflect my nameplate. Please use the values on your motor to determine which values you should enter in here. Next is power factor, which should be on the nameplate as well as the next setting for motor nominal voltage. This is followed by the motor nominal frequency, which is typically 60 Hz in North America, but may require a different frequency if listed on the nameplate. For standard setups, the wizard should be complete, but if the macro was set to something other than standard earlier, such as multi-pump or PID, the drive will prompt the user to start up an application mini wizard that focuses on application-specific features for that macro. Now that my values are programmed into the motor, I can run the motor. But before I do that, I want to show how to navigate through this menu to change any parameters if needed. The main menu has a letter to define each mode. The important ones to look at for a basic startup is P for parameter, M for monitoring, and O for operate mode. I can scroll to P for parameter, where I can select the basic parameters, analog inputs and outputs, digital inputs and outputs, and more. I will push OK on basic parameters, which is listed as P1. You can notice that the numbers of the parameters are listed on the left side, making it easier to find parameters from the manual. If I was looking for the Excel time, which is parameter P1.3, I can scroll to it here. If the parameter I am looking for is P12.1, I can press the back button and then scroll to P12 for preset speed and then press OK to see P12.1. I will go back to the main menu now and go to M for monitoring. I can press OK on M1 for output frequency. I will change the drive to local operation, which I will be prompted before the change is made to prevent accidental changes. Now I can hit start. I will push the back button and go to O for operate mode. Here I will scroll to R12 for the keypad reference. By pressing OK, I can change the parameter, but the change is too slow to make a difference. If I push the right arrow while the drive is in edit mode, I can now select specific digits with the arrow keys to make more significant changes to the frequency that can be reflected in real time. I can now press OK to save. Eaton Cutler-Hammer's PowerXL DG1 AC drive, along with thousands of other products and services, are available at galco.com.